Hello, welcome to the Winter Shelter webinar. We will review Case Management Basics, Program Comprehensive Needs Assessment, and the Individualized Service Plan. Hi, my name is Brenda Threet. I am the Shelter Systems Manager at LASA. This webinar contains two sections. The first section will review Winter Shelter Case Management Basics, and how to input this information into HMIS. The second section will review the Comprehensive Needs Assessment and Linkage Performance Targets, the Individualized Service Plan, or ISP, and where to find these documents. You will access the Comprehensive Needs Assessment and Individualized Service Plan documents in HMIS. Simply click on Client Profile, then New. The milestone is Comprehensive Needs Assessment, and the activity is Comprehensive Need. Enter the date that the Comprehensive Needs Assessment occurs. Save, and the questions will appear. It is important, do not skip questions. This will break the jump logic, and the information will be scrambled. Again, do not skip questions. Answer all the documentation questions. The questions map to the Comprehensive Needs Assessment. And these documents are posted on the LASA website. The link is posted here. Answer all the documentation questions first. Next, you will answer all the Comprehensive Needs questions. And then the first section that will come up after that is the housing history. Follow all the questions sequentially and answer them accordingly. Clear the dashes out of all the areas that have multiple response and check only the appropriate response field, then click Next. This is the Client Profile Comprehensive Needs Assessment in HMIS. You can see that newest circle and the milestone is Comprehensive Needs. Enter the date that the Comprehensive Needs Assessment occurs and save. Voila! Here are your questions. And you can see that the questions are sequential. Please answer them accordingly. That is very important. The Comprehensive Needs Assessment sets a goal of 25% of the number of unduplicated clients served. The importance of this assessment is that it goes beyond the required HMIS program entry questions. It has a strong housing barrier assessment focus and has proven to be an effective tool in housing placement. The formula to determine your targeted number of clients to receive a comprehensive needs assessment is to take your total number of unduplicated individuals and multiply that number by 25%. For example, if you serve 100 unduplicated individuals, 25% of 100 would be 25 persons that you must identify to be case managed and to receive the Comprehensive Needs Assessment. The Comprehensive Needs Assessment document is provided by LASA and can be found on the HMIS webpage. Verification. We know that we need to have verification. That means a signed and dated comprehensive needs assessment verifying that a comprehensive needs assessment was made and completed must be placed in the participant's case file, and case notes should be entered into HMIS. It is acceptable to print out the HMIS version of the comprehensive needs assessment, have the individual sign and date it, and place this version in the individual's case file. Documentation of linkages to services. The second target is documentation of linkages to services. Clients should be linked to services that address their individual barriers to housing. This target is set at 35%. Not 35% of all your unduplicated clients, but 35% is calculated out of the 25% of clients who have received a comprehensive needs assessment. You're only required to link case-managed clients to services, which would be that 25%. So it's not a whole lot. For example, if the number of unduplicated clients served is 100, then the number of clients to receive case management in a comprehensive needs assessment would be 25% of 100, or 25 clients. and you are required to link 35% of those clients who received a comprehensive needs assessment. 35% of 25 clients is 8.75, and we round it up to 9 clients who received a comprehensive needs assessment should also be linked to services. And here is the linkages page. Linkages to services may include, but are not limited to, documentation that addresses physical disability, developmental disabilities, chronic health issues, mental health issues, substance abuse, financial situations, criminal backgrounds. And from this page, you will see you will click on the linkage tab, and then you will answer the questions sequentially. Finding these documents. These documents can be found on the HMIS webpage. The link is here. From the HMIS webpage, simply click on Providers Tools, then Document Library, scroll down to the Winter Shelter Documentation, click on Comprehensive Needs and Assessments, and you will have accessed the WSP Comprehensive Assessment and Individualized Service Plan. An individualized service plan is a completed ISP. Individualized service plan. A completed individualized service plan, ISP, documenting service linkages addressing clients' barriers to housing must be included in the participant's case file. And again, linkages to services may include but are not limited to documentation that addresses physical disabilities, developmental disabilities, chronic health issues, mental health issues, substance abuse, financial situations, and criminal background. Note, complete the WSP Comprehensive Needs Assessment and ISP in the order the questions are asked. This document includes a checklist of required paperwork an individual needs to have in order to have successful case management. Follow each section and allow the client to answer each section as completely as they can. It is not necessary to read each checklist to the client. Simply allow them to answer each question to the best of their ability. When you reach the debt table, you will have reached the end of the comprehensive needs assessment questions. All the questions after the debt table correspond to the individualized service plan. The ISP is meant to be an action plan that you and the client will use to track progress. You will ask yourself, what is the best housing track for this individual? You will list the priority areas and any action items you set for the participant. This report tracks permanent and temporary housing under report sections F and G. Please include the verified housing placement activity and proper destination under the program exit page. Destination types per HUD 2014 standards are permanent destinations, which include destinations owned by the client, no ongoing subsidy, owned by the client with ongoing subsidy, rentals by the client, no ongoing subsidy, rental by the client, VASH subsidy, rental by the client, Section 8, permanent supportive housing for homeless persons, living with family, permanent tenure, or living with friends, permanent tenure. Temporary destinations include emergency shelters, transitional housing, staying with family, temporary tenure, staying with friends, temporary tenure, safe haven, hotel, or motel. The ISP is meant to be a living document, meaning there will be multiple notes and updates to the ISP as the client progresses or action items get amended. The ISP will be updated accordingly. There is a signature line for the program participant, case management, and should your supervisor choose to be included, there is a signature line for the supervisor. And this next slide is a picture of the housing placement page in HMIS. You will find this under case notes. As you can see, that's circled. New would be circled for this being a new client. And the activity would be housing placement, and you will list that activity on this page. Wow, that completes the Comprehensive Needs Assessment ISP webinar. Your efficient and complete documentation will result in successful transitions for your clients into programs that will enhance their quality of life. Congratulations.